Welcome back to Tales of Zelia, Part 6. Honestly? Yeah.
You seem to know your way around a fight.
Yeah, I studied self-defense when I was a kid.
They say that even the best trained soldiers may panic in the face of actual combat. Yet you seem completely together.
Well, I had a friend I trained with who used to shout sparring time and attack me out of the blue. So it's probably thanks to her.
I see.
I'd always wind up on the ground covered in bruises.
I'm sorry to dredge up such painful memories.
What? No, it's not like that.
Don't all bullied children say that?
Bullied? That's not what... Wait. Was it?
Well, let's go.
Attack.
Nope. You said you tried not to kill people. Stop incinerating them. It's the only piece of advice I can give.
This is a good kick. All right. This is a good.
My sword rings true.
What is that?
A Spyrex weapon. I knew it.
From the Genesis Age. Huh? What are you doing?
So this is what humans call irony. Naming this weapon after Kresnik.
Listen up. We must destroy that which harms man and spirit.
Those are the four great spirits. So that really makes her Maxwell?
Are you gonna try and stop it? Do you know what you're doing?
That's it.
Leela! Look down!
Stop! Or you'll be dragged in with it.
Spirits? have lost the power of the four great spirits. What are you gonna do now? There's no way you could destroy that device without their power.
You have a point. Perhaps if I were to return to Niakara. Listen, you've been a great help, Jude. Thank you. You should go home now.
Wait!
Later.